Hey, what's up guys, welcome back. You watching for a day. Most top users are afraid of using custom ROMs because they think custom ROMs are developed by third party developers and they will hack their devices, but the reality is that new generation custom world providing users the true potential to control access of their device data by third party servers. Today I'm going to review new VoltageOS 5.0 Android 16 ROM, which now integrated with Grephen OS sandbox feature. New app sandboxing feature helps you to provide ultimate secure environment in your device, which none of stock ROMs offers. We'll also review all new user interface changes and features that this ROM offers for your old aged device, along with all bugs present in this ROM. So watch this video until the end. Now without further delay, let's get started. Any device can boot and use this ROM. Please check iCard video link and description for more details. I booted this build on my OnePlus 9RT, so let's begin with device details of this ROM. This is the unofficial latest Android 16 QPR1 based VoltageOS 5.0 version. Security patches of this ROM is of latest August 2025. Developer is DozeOff. Build date of this ROM is of 20th August 2025. So everything is up to date. Let's check out how to set up sandbox environment of this ROM and how it provides most secure environment on your Android phone. Once you boot the ROM, you will find even though you flashed the GApps build, still there are no any Google Play Store or Google Play services are available in this ROM. To activate them, you need to install GriffinOS App Store. Its link is given in the description. Download and install the application. Open it and there you will get the Play Store and Google Play Services application. Download and install them. Now you can open Play Store and there set up your Google account. Once done, you can install and use all Google applications on your device. Now in the notification, you will get the notification as Sandbox or Google Play is running on your device. If you tap on this, it will redirect you to the Sandbox or Google Play setting. Here in User's Guide, you will get the introduction of Sandbox Google Play. In next option, you get the Play Services and Play Store information. By using Google Services setting, we can change some settings of Google account. So what's the use of Sandbox or Google Play Services? This is a secure environment which didn't allow any Google applications or even Google Play services to access any content of your device without your permission. You will get each and every notifications in the status bar whenever any application asks for different permissions. Even whenever we install any new applications from the Play Store, we have to give permission to install the application first. Automatic installation of application will not done by Google Play services itself. So no hackers or not even Google can able to install unknown applications on your device without your permission. GriffinOS App Store itself offers some inbuilt applications like Auditor, GriffinOS Camera, PDF Viewer and many more. Apps update notification will be available at the top right corner with numbers of applications available to update. Each and every third party or Google applications access will be immediately notified to you once application starts to access them. Like this Play Integrity application, when I tried to check Play Integrity's sandbox environment, immediately notified me Play Integrity API tried to access system integrity. Here we can take control over the applications by enabling some toggles like block users attempt, show user notification, and even we get the option to check which application user Play Integrity API permissions. That's a pretty cool feature. Next, under the network and internet setting, we get the separate option to use standard Google or GriffinOS servers for some activities. Same settings can be used for attestation, key provision, and for widband provisioning. So using Google services within sandbox environment provides you true control of device in hand of device users. So what are the new changes added by VoltageOS in this update? The team added Express Citizen and a QS panel from Android 16 QPR1, along with the toggles to enable or disable the status bar icons. But user interface of QS panel toggles, icons, brightness slider have new user interface touch like some other custom ROMs added in their ROMs like RisingOS. Except that settings panel and other user interface elements are similar like Android 16 QPR1. If you ask me about customizations offered by this ROM have dedicated customization option called as Power Up. Here all basic customization stuffs are available like status bar, themes, lock screen, miscellaneous, etc. I will not go in the deeper of these settings, but few things are important like in the themes, we get the transparent notification panel toggle, and in the miscellaneous settings, we get spoofing and plain reality bypass features that other new ROMs are offering. Next ROM comes with its new VoltageOS launcher as a default launcher, which also offers all basic customization features for icons, home screen, app drawer, recents, and miscellaneous features. In the recent panel shortcuts, this ROM have multiple new options like lock, unlock, free from multi-window mode, app kill, similar like close button and split screen. In the display setting, we get the HDR display toggle, which helps to peak display brightness when HDR content is played on your device. We can even control HDR display intensity using slider control. Windows level blur toggle enables the blur effect while accessing the recents, QS, and notification panel, which looks like glass effect. Next, under the system, in a gesture navigation, we get the taskbar. I think this is the only ROM which adopted forgotten taskbar feature in Android 16 based ROM. Using taskbar provides you easy access to app drawer and all dock applications anywhere in the system by just swiping over navigation bar pill. Its opening and closing animations are very smooth and looks very nice. In same setting, we get the advanced swipe back gesture, which offers us long swipe back gesture shortcuts for left and right, with vertical left and right L-type gestures. So we can assign any shortcuts for these gestures and can improve multitasking features of your device. So we've seen each and every details. Let's check out some bugs and their solutions for GSI users. I think this is the first ever GSI ROM which are working for your network for me, and it should work for you also. Just go to the system and trouble setting, there in IMS setting, tap create IMS APN, then download and install IMS APK. Next, enable all three toggles and reboot your device. In 5G network setting, use 5G as default network. Now you can able to use 5G internet and calling services on your Snapdragon device if your device supports it. Otherwise, LTE calling will surely works for you. Fingerprint is not available in this ROM, but face unlock is available and it's pretty accurate and fast. Punch hole camera cutout issue is still persist in this ROM and it's not completely solvable even after enabling punch hole cutout setting available in the display cutout option. All play integrity checks are failing, still I am able to use all major banking and payment applications. Only Beam UPI is not working. Next one is a major issue. Bluetooth connection is working, but I can't able to get any audio in earbuds even after connecting my OnePlus Bullets. Bluetooth issue is a major issue for me, except that other things are negligible. Performance of ROM is of next level, everything is buttery smooth. So I definitely recommend you this build if you want secure environment using app sandbox feature along with fluid user interface and some major customization without heavy steps. This is all about for today guys. Hope you liked our work. Then please do like and share this video, subscribe to our channel, press the bell icon for notifications of our upcoming content related to review of such custom ROMs and GSI builds. Thanks for watching. See you next time. Take care. Bye bye.